pothole season is coming early this year.
And I've been here 9 years. It's probably one of the worst years I've seen.
Chris Mitchell, an SHA crew team leader, out on I-70 Monday, patching things up as fast as his crew can. Right now, it's a temporary fix using a cold patch just to fill in the holes.
If the weather's good, it'll last probably a couple of weeks until the weather gets bad again, and then once we start plowing and salting, it'll start coming back out.
And the workload's so heavy this year that work crews here on I-70 will repair potholes just like this one over and over again to the tune of hundreds a week.
It takes us roughly 6 hours a day.
That's just constant work.
Constant working, yes.
For fiscal year 2018, state highway crews repaired more than 25,000 cubic yards of potholes. And this year, that number is expected to grow. Why? All the rain we had last year, combined with freezing temperatures, followed by much warmer temperatures.
You take that moisture and then the freeze-thaw cycle, and then you've got potholes all over the place.
And while all these repairs are being made, drivers are reminded of the move-over law, requiring motorists to safely move away from vehicles on the shoulders of the highway.
We have arrow boards on trucks, and just pay attention. I mean, if you see a right arrow, move over to the right. You see the left, move over to the left. And just when you see all these flashing lights, just pay attention to them.
And state highway officials say that they will start making permanent fixes towards the end of March, early April, when temperatures are consistently above 50 degrees. If you see a pothole on an area state highway or road, we've got a link on our website, WBALTV.com, and on our mobile app on how you can report those. We're live in Ellicott City tonight. I'm Lowell Melser, WBAL TV 11 News.